Today, I'm excited to show you Wave's IMMERSIVE WRAPPER, a game-changing plugin for immersive mixing formats such as Dolby Atmos. Whether you're working with multi-channel beds or object-based tracks, this tool solves the common bus processing problem in immersive audio workflows, and I'm going to show you why it's a game changer. I quickly want to show you the old system that a lot of music mixers in the Dolby Atmos immersive space are using, and that is object-based bus. So here I've got a folder track that's got 714, and I've put inside it a object-based bus, and it's all mono tracks. Here you can see each speaker position, including an LFE, and then on each channel I've got Shep's Omni channel, and each channel has got a little bit of saturation to kind of just emulate when you cram a stereo mix a little bit, just to get a bit of harmonic distortion, a bit of crunch, but also there's some soft compression that is sidechain. So here you can see my sidechain, which is everything. So objects and the buses all sending to that, and then that is compressing everything. And so you put this on each individual channel of your bus, as well as the objects within your mix. And that just means everything kind of has that glue that you get from, say, just putting a compressor on a stereo bus. And what you have to do is basically for every single instance, you group them. So within Pro Tools, you can group it so that when I change this setting, you see that it changes on the other one. So I can basically change them all in one hit. But now we can simplify our templates and work quicker using the IMMERSIVE WRAPPER by just putting that on our master bus. Let's just pretend this is a bed and not a folder track at the moment. We can add our IMMERSIVE WRAPPER in here. So it says 714. And we can add, all right, I'm going to pretend like we want to add the same thing, which is the Omni. It'd be great if I could type it in right. So we add the Omni in. And so this is now applied on every single channel of my 714 setup. And basically, I want to do the same thing. So I'm going to put a little bit of compression. We're going to put a bit of saturation. I can't remember exactly what settings I had here. I probably did some EQing, who knows. But just to get a bit of sound over the overall, like just add some character, bit of distortion because, you know, a nice master might have a little bit of crunch. So it's just to match the master track. But what you've got options here for control link groups is you can either go none and literally every single channel, left, center, right, you can control them individually, or we can do all of them. So basically anything I do here applies to every single instance, every mono instance on every channel. What you can also do is obviously just go, all right, let's just change the front. So maybe you want to compress the heights a bit more than the fronts, or, you know, whatever it might be, you have the option to control those separately. But you can also make your own user group. So if you want to make a user group, you could do surrounds and tops together and control them separately to the front. Maybe you want them to be more saturated or compressed, or even roll off some bottom end, whatever it might be, you've got those options. The other thing that you've also got is internal side chaining. So internal side chaining basically is how much each channel is going to affect the plugin. So if we select our channel one here, you can mix how much each channel is affecting the overall, say, compression, because obviously we're compressing this. So, you know, based on the information that's coming in, and you can adjust here so that maybe it's mostly the information that's coming from the front, because everything else is not, you know, maybe the tops is mostly just sort of reverbs and not much going on, but you mostly want it controlled by the fronts, so you can turn these down as much as you want. And you can also do separate mixes, so you can have up to 6 sidechain mixes that you also then can adjust individually. So if we press that here, so obviously mix one is all the way up to the top, but you can adjust that. So maybe you know that like your fronts, number one is always your fronts, number two is always your surrounds, and then you can adjust this based on your liking as you're going through. And it just gives you more options. You can also solo your sidechain. You can actually monitor what's coming through the sidechain, which is great. And you can obviously select whether you want RMS or, you know, the max sound. If you want heaps of flexibility when it comes to how you're processing the sound, say you want to compress it based on only the front speakers. So with something like this, we're sidechaining the compressor and you only want it to be the front. So let's say you've mixed in your sidechain mixer just the fronts. You have the option here with this weight fader to either go between your sidechain mixer or the input itself, so everything that's coming into it. So you could just turn this into input only, and then everything that's coming into that plugin will affect how that compressor is compressing. But if you really want to, let's just say you had the kick in the center channel and all you want to do is compress everything based off the kick in the center channel, I don't know why you'd want to do that, but if you did, then you could select sidechain here and in your mixer only have the center channel feeding it. You get the idea. So that's a really cool and handy feature to be able to do that. It's good practice that if you're doing some bus processing on your bus, you should do it on your objects as well to really glue the whole mix together. So I've got my immersive wrapper there on my master bus, and then I'm going to put the immersive wrapper onto this object, which is just a vocal delay that sits up the top and at the back. And we're going to add the same plugin Omni here. Okay, so same plugin, and we want them to be treated the exact same way. One thing that you should do before we do any global grouping, which I'm going to show, is we want to copy our settings here and we're going to paste them here. So these two are now set the same. So they've got the identical settings, and now we're going to add a global group. So this global group will be named based off the plugin you've got and where it's located. So it's on the 714 channel. And so we go over here and we say we want to add it to that same group. And now if we change that, it changes them all. So it's kind of like adding groups in Pro Tools, like we did back here with our object-based stuff. But this is a lot more simple in the sense that, you know, adding groups on plugins, you know, plugin controls can get a bit messy. And at least, you know, this way you've got your group setting. So you can also still do your mix. So you'll see here that you're sending the mix here and the mix here to sidechain mixer one. So it's great that it all just, they just kind of work together seamlessly. So when you change one, it changes the other. There's two main reasons why I'm really excited about this plugin. First of all, there are so many great stereo plugins that I love from Waves, including Low Air, BB Tubes, things like Max Level. Like, there's so many great practical plugins out there that you could put on a bus to, you know, if you're working quick or depending on the project, that you need to just level stuff out quickly. The fact that you can now do that in 714 and use all these great stereo plugins is fantastic. And secondly, using this workflow now with the immersive wrapper, it is going to reduce the size of my audio post-production templates. So this is my mega Dolby Atmos audio post-production template that I'm working on or have been working on, and I just want to tighten it up before I sell it on my website. But if you go to noisypost.com.au/shop, you'll see my other templates. I've got some for DaVinci Resolve as well as Pro Tools. But this one, basically it's got, you know, folder groups with all the channels in it. So you've got dialogue, this is my dialogue group, and it's got ADR, Wah-wah, it's got reverbs, all that sort of stuff, through to the VCAs to control it. And this is my master section. So I've got the objects and the object beds that I've created here. They down mix into 7.1, 5.1 and stereo, and you've got all the stems. So you literally have everything you could possibly need to deliver through to your client. It's a huge template. It's big. You need to have Ultimate. You need to have it for all the channels. So by being able to just use a single bus and not using objects, I'll be able to reduce this down and just simplify it. But then I also get to use Waves the way I would like to use it, and that's in immersive settings. I just want to take a quick sidebar just to let you know of my education platform called the Noisy Post Shadowing Network. You can shadow me as I work on real life projects from feature films, TV pilots to documentaries. I've currently got about 80 or so hours of content up there, and I've got a heap more as well. You can watch my process from start to finish, whether it's audio post-production or also mixing in Dolby Atmos. So go check it out, head to shadowing.network for more information. If you love your Waves plugins as I do, and you're mixing in an immersive format, whether it's for music or films, then you need to get your hands on the Immersive Wrapper by Waves. I've been Benni Knop, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one.